Hey YouTube, welcome back to part 5, I think, of Let's Play Mass Effect 2. The only thing that you missed between the last part and this part is I put another upgrade slot into armor-piercing ammo. That's all you missed. Nothing too important. I'm gonna boost one more armor cache clans and go to bed. Yo, that sounds like a plan. I mean, I'm probably going to be up for quite a while now since I got caffeinated coffee. Just need to wait for it to cool down before I start drinking it. I can't drink hot coffee. Alright, so I need to go to all the merchants and see what's specifically available here. And also, there's a couple of quests here that we can do as well. But we're going to grab Garrus and Morden. Because everybody loves Garrus and Morden. Alright, so we're good there. Okay, so Garrus, first of all, we're just gonna upgrade you all the way there. We're gonna make you... Turian Renegade. There you go, and then Morden, you're still missing a couple points, unfortunately. Okay, Garrus, what do you got for equipment? You're using a Madoc. I guess that's alright. And no, you're gonna use a Mantis. And what am I able to use here? I actually kinda like the Predator Pistol a little bit more. Arc Projector is fantastic, so we're gonna continue using that.
The plague has been completely eradicated, Shepard. I have also run searches for reports on Archangel. The various mercenary groups appear to believe that he is dead.
Works for me.
As it should. Alright, so we're gonna head into the lower section first here. Alright, now, this first merchant, there's a trick to him. For those of you that are playing along with me, hopefully there are those of you that are. There's the trick. Don't buy anything from him right away. Just talk to him a little bit.
Every credit goes toward a ticket to get me off this forsaken rock.
I'm gonna paragon these guys, though.
Parts and equipment. Maybe we can make an arrangement.
Well... seem like a decent person, but you can't breathe a word of it to Harry.
Of course.
Then we have a deal. Maybe I'll
now you think that, hey, I got a discount, I can buy something now. Don't just yet.
What brought a nice kid
keep
like
talking
Peter
to
Omega?
Him.
My pilgrimage. What money I had got stolen within a few days, so I decided to sell salvaged parts. You can see how that turned out. Harrod's forcing me to sell high, and I can't even afford a ticket off this station.
Why does Harrod control your prices?
Harrod made me swear not to undercut it, no matter what. He was here first, so it's his right. But no one will buy from me when he's so much cheaper. You can't save enough money for a ticket off the station.
I can go talk to Harrod for you. Get him to ease up.
I won't stop you. If you can convince him to lay off, maybe I'll get off this station after all. His shop's up the ramp, near where Marsh sells his goods. Anything you can do will be much appreciated.
I have to go.
Please check with my kiosk to see what I have for sale. Thank you.
This is what you want to do. So you want to go back and talk to Harrod. That's the upstairs, yeah. So we can talk to this dude. For some reason.
Tell Captain Gavorn we not kill anyone today.
I don't know a Captain Gavorn. Why would I tell him anything?
Not trust you. Tell Gavorn we know his tricks. We not kill anyone today.
There seem to be a lot of Vorcha on Omega.
Go away. Talk too much. Gavorn's fox get no more. We leave.
Good talking to you.
No more talk. We know Gavorn's tricks. We leave.
Okay. You do that, bud.
Walking around in this place makes me sick. People still dying. Strong, still exploiting the loot. Nothing I get here to make a dentist.
Vorcha adaptation interesting. Not just biological. Social as well. Urban area adapted to them in return. Large concentration.
That's into the bar, right? Yeah, no, I don't need to go that way. I made a wrong turn somewhere. Maybe because I'm dumb. Yeah, no, because I wake up here. Oh, this is what I need. Alright. Okay, so we are trying to find Harriet, whom is actually up over here.
Tentatively excited. Welcome, human. What can I get for you?
Tell me about your deal with the Quarian over there.
Suspicious. If I had made such a deal, I would certainly not be in.
I love the cigar.
Discuss it. Accusatory. I don't understand how it is any concern of yours.
What if you and I make a deal? You let him set his own prices, and I won't break your legs.
With barely contained terror.
With barely contained terror.
I haven't even started.
Resignation. Very well. I will release the Quarian from his promise. Conciliatory. To show there is no ill will, I offer you a discount on my own wares.
And there you go.
Courteously, have a fine day.
So now, I can go back. Talk to the Quarian and say that he is all good.
I heard you spoke to Harriet. Thank you so much. At this rate, I'll be off the station in no time.
How much do you need to get off Omega?
I still need 1,000 credits to pay my way, but I couldn't let you do that. This is my mistake on my pilgrimage.
Nope.
It's my problem.
Here you go. 1,000 credits. Get out of here.
Thank you. With this, I can finally continue on my pilgrimage. I'm going to buy my ticket right now. Thank you again.
And of course, we can still browse the shop with the extra discount, which is fantastic. So obviously, we're going to spend quite a bit here. Heavy weapon ammo, shotgun damage, I don't need to really worry about. So I'm just going to make sure that I'm buying the most important stuff right away, so at least I know what's there first. Okay, so there's the VIP room. Nothing going on over here. Nothing going on over here. We are gonna look at the Omega Market, though. And what's up, Marsh?
I might have something here for humans. Not much.
I'm in the mood to spend some.
Of course, before you go to every single kiosk, talk to the merchant. Get yourself a discount.
Unless you're willing to risk black market.
I'd rather deal with you than give money to those thieves. You sure we can't make a deal?
Look, I can't compete with the black market. I have to make a profit. I'll do what I can. But don't tell anyone or I'll lose my shirt.
There you go. Okay, so we got... that's 3K. That's pretty good. And of course, the models we have to get right away. Sniper rifle damage. Oh, 4x. Okay. Alright, so sniper rifle damage, obviously, I use that weapon quite a bit. So we're going to buy that upgrade.
This should come in handy.
And where am I going right now? I'm too dumb, I don't know where I'm going. We're going up here. We're gonna browse Harriet's stuff. Alright, so we got the visor, which is actually a pretty good thing. Hack module. This is actually a really good upgrade, so we're gonna buy that.
I'll take it.
Good lord, her voice is really loud. Actually, I think we can buy out all the shops here, which is kind of fantastic, gonna be honest. The scholarships have allowed several dozen young men and women to leave gangs and to join the military
or enroll in school. This is valuable.
Yeah, and we're still gonna have quite a bit left over here. So we're gonna have 200k left over, 206k, which is exactly where I want it to be. We have all the necessary upgrades. Alright, so, I wanna actually go back this way. So there's one last thing that we can do here. It's late, and the only one around is that screeching prophet and a few forges scratching for food. Oh, I need to go up this way, I think. No, wait, where's the party room somewhere? Alright, it's over here. You can watch the dancer, of course, but that's just kind of weird. Actually, no, there's two things we can do here still. Well,
I should have warned you, Shepard. I'm sorry.
How much did I drink?
One drink. That's all it takes. That racist Batarian bastard. Looks like you broke the first rule of Omega. Don't order a drink at Afterlife if you're human.
Humans aren't welcome at Afterlife?
It's just that one Batarian bartender. He's got a stick up his ass about a bunch of Batarians that died a while back. No one does a thing about it, though. Humans ain't exactly held in high regard around here.
That bartender tried to poison me?
Tried is the word. As far as I know, you're the first human to survive.
Nice.
Me and my friend Jake went there to celebrate our new shipping business. He got real drunk. And an hour later, he was puking blood.
I'll give that bartender a taste of his own medicine.
They won't be expecting you, that's for sure. Give that Batarian bastard what he deserves.
The laugh, though. Alright, so we need to go down again. Whenever I'm on this quest, I always get turned around and I come out the wrong way. Like, I actually always end up back in the marketplace instead of at the bar. Get him, he deserves it. Alright, chat, decide. Paragon or Renegade?
Do I know? No, no, humans all look the same. Here, have a drink on the house.
Renegade, Paragon. Renegade or Paragon? Choose it, nerds! Let's see if this coffee is good now. Ah, perfect drinking temperature. Renegade. Yo.
But you drank? You shouldn't get. Wait. You don't want me to.
Now, drink it.
I no. You can't. I
drink it, or I'll blind you one eye at a time.
There we go. Alright, so there's a thing we can do here still. First of all, we're gonna run into someone that we had dealings with in Mass Effect 1, I think. Oh, where is she? Interesting. There's supposed to be someone back here.
Some work?
It's him.
It depends on what Arya has in mind.
Arya's gotten word that some blood-packed mercs plan to kill an old acquaintance of hers, a Krogan named Patriarch. She'd like you to keep that from happening.
Alright, time to ask a couple questions.
What's the blood-packed problem with Patriarch?
If you've met Patriarch, you know. He can't keep his damn mouth shut. Some people don't appreciate his stories, especially when he dips into non-fiction.
What's Arya's interest in protecting him?
Patriarch was one of her deadliest enemies back in the old days. Now she keeps what's left of him around as a trophy. As long as he lives, he's a perfect example of what happens when you go up against Arya.
Why come to me? Arya's usual muscle not up for the job?
Because Arya said so. What other reason do you need?
People like Arya don't do things without a damn good reason. I want to hear it.
Fine, but I didn't tell you this, got me? If it gets out that Arya's protecting Patriarch, well, that can look like a weakness. And some people might want to exploit that. You're not on her payroll, so you helping Patriarch just seems like a random act of kindness.
Tell Arya I'm not interested in running her errands for her.
How disappointing. Oh, great. If you come to your senses. Patriarch isn't dead yet. You can still take
I'll look into it.
Good. Patriarch's downstairs, likely surrounded by his fans. Get him into hiding until the mercs move on. Come back here when it's done, and you'll get your due.
I'll be back when the job's done.
Good luck.
Now, I have a... I am subscribed to someone on YouTube who did a playthrough of this game, and his options for this part were wrong. Like, I mean, technically they weren't wrong, but it's not exactly an outcome I would wish for, so I'm gonna do something that I want to do, because honestly, I've only ever done this guy's quest once before, and I kind of forget what I'm able to do, so... I just know how to get that one option I don't want.
Kill the family first, then he'll get angry and come at you stupid. And then you kill him. Don't think I know you, human. I'm the Patriarch. Arya's Patriarch. What do you want?
What do you know about Arya?
A few centuries ago, Omega was my rock. When Arya arrived, she had nothing but the clothes on her back. I thought she was another dancer. She killed half my men and convinced the rest that she could run this place better than I did. She came for me here in this bar. We tore this place apart. She crushed one of my hearts, shattered half the bones of my body, and left me alive.
What made her decide to leave you alive?
No, she doesn't destroy what she can use. She said I could have all my old comforts if I served as her advisor. I knew how things worked. I knew who to lean on, who to smack down, who to smile at. And everyone who respected me saw me beaten, broken. They knew that as strong as I'd been, he was stronger.
Rumor has it some people want you dead. Know anything about that?
Well, let me think of a few. I know things. Old secrets, old grudges. A few floors you can dig up to find bodies underneath. Someone who wanted to weaken Arya might come after me. They do it to get to her, you see. Not for me. Anymore to have enemies of my own.
Why do they call you Patriarch?
It's like an Asari matriarch, only male. It was Arya's little joke. After she took me down, she let me live, kept me around as an advisor and a trophy.
A Krogan as old as you must have some great stories.
I killed a lot of people, lived well, and was beaten by a small Asari who keeps me around as an example. My time is done. Anyone I killed is long forgotten. The stories are Arya's now.
Some people want you dead. I've been asked to move you to safety.
Well, of course. Arya wouldn't want me hurt. It would make her look bad. Perhaps Arya's reputation is no longer my concern. Perhaps I will stay. See who thinks me important enough to kill.
This is the one I wanted.
Here's an idea. Let me handle the assassins for you.
And so your name grows, while I remain an old man who lets others fight his battle.
Hartley.
No. You remain a powerful warlord with forces at his command, not just Arya's trophy.
Well, you could be. You could be my Trent, fighting for my honor. If you would do this for me, I would be grateful. I might even be a Krogan again.
Yep. That's the outcome I wanted. Uh I need to read the journal here real quick. Find the floods in or near afterlife. So if I did this... Oh, hi.
Out of our way, human.
You hear from Patriarch?
What if we are? You gonna do something about it?
Yep.
Patriarch says hello.
Is that it? That's all they sent? Really? That's kind of pathetic.
Kill them all. Everyone knows that the Patriarch is not to be crossed. Thanks to you, Arya may think of me as more than a trophy. A real advisor to me. Or even a threat.
Use this. Don't ever let anyone think you're weak again.
Thanks to you. I am a Krogan. By the way, be careful with Arya. She will approve of what you've done, I think. But not of you altering the balance of Omega. I think it reminds her too much of herself.
Hmm. Alright, so now I need to go back to Grizz. Tell him I did the job. Also, Renegade and Paragon out of that, which is fantastic.
Later today, we interview Counselor Anderson. The tireless former soldier has put down his guns to build bridges with numerous trees.
Arya wants to speak with you. She heard you took on the Bloodknight assassin yourself.
Word has it that Patriarch's Krant took out the men sent here to kill him. Funny, I didn't know he had a Krant. I guess you're working on old information. Hmm. Well, no one would dare cross him with such a powerful Krant standing up for him. It's not what I asked, but you got the job done.
Of course.
Do you need something else? This data pad was on one of the mercs going after Archangel. They were coming for you next. Let me see. Interesting. Would someone like to tell me how this information slipped the net?
I love how she tosses it at him.
You've done a lot for me, Shepard. Let me return the favor. We're sending your coordinates to a cache on an uncharted world. You want it? It's yours.
We can use any help we can get.
Whatever you find is yours to deal with.
Alright. We're good. I think that's all we need on Omega.
Maybe I'll come back later.
You should find a nice young man to keep you warm in the meantime. You look like you need to lose level.
Ha ha. That woman looks like she got a lot of sand in her kitchen. What? Bruh. Bruh. Alright, so let me take a look at the journal here, what has to be done. Citadel. Overlord, Project Firewalker, don't need to worry about that. Normandy Carside, don't need to worry about that. I thought this rice ice brandy comes from over here. Like, I swore it did. Or was it a place on the Citadel? No, okay. No, I don't remember what it was.
Certain foundation is likely to close by the end of this fiscal year.
I need to talk to some people, maybe just to figure out exactly where I'm specifically at. On this goddamn quest line, because I remember that. Okay, so there are like three things to get for your crew. There's the rice ice brandy, the groceries, and then there's the power cells or something like that for engineering. And I remember that you get one of them on Omega. Or two of them on Omega. I thought you always got the Sorice Ice Brandy on Omega. I could have sworn that you did.
No messages for you, Commander.
I'll go investigate, though. Oh, right, I bought a bunch of upgrades here. Well... Alright, well, I can't get that to upgrade because don't have one more sniper rifle research item, so maybe I have to do some more shopping on Citadel after we do a couple jobs. Let me go down to engineering to make sure and actually talk to the engineering guys. Because I think you get the power cells from Omega. Okay, I drank that coffee. I'm going to be vibrating in about 20 minutes. Alright, need to make sure where to get this rice ice brandy. Okay, so the Sorice Brandy I can get anywhere except for, Omega. Okay, that's what I was remembering wrong. But did I talk to these guys about their thing?
You came all the way down here to see
nope,
us.
I did not.
You're speaking to our commanding officer.
I'm touring the ship, getting to know my crew.
I'm Engineer Ken Donnelly, handling the power control systems. This is Gabby.
That's Engineer Gabriella Daniels, actually. I'm responsible for the propulsion systems.
What can we do for you, Commander?
Are you set up okay down here?
We can't complain. I just wish it didn't take so long to calibrate the FBA arrays.
Kenneth, you're complaining.
What kind of problems are you having?
When they upgraded the Normandy design, they got a bit sloppy with the FBA couplings. I won't bore you with the tech, but there's an array of attenuators in the primary power transfer system that channels the field bleed.
Kenneth, you're boring the commander with tech. In short, if we had T6 FBA couplings installed, it'd save us a lot of maintenance time each day.
Why isn't something like that already installed?
It's probably just a design oversight. Efficiency isn't affected. It's a maintenance issue.
Also, the T6 model can be hard to find. Nash and Stellar Dynamics discontinued them.
We could probably find used ones in the Omega markets, but we have no time for shore leave.
I'll do it.
Carry on.
Will do, Commander. I'm amazed Shepard came down to here.
Alright, so now we need to go back onto Omega, and I know exactly where to get the couplings. It's at the dude that we paid for his ticket back to his pilgrimage on. That's his deal, I think. Or at least that's where I remember getting them. If I'm wrong again, I'm going to be absolutely mad at myself. I don't think we got any level ups, did we? Nope. And of course, those two are not there yet, so don't need to worry about their questline either. Actually, I don't think they appear until Ilium. Yep, there they are. And now we just literally head back to the Normandy. I actually honestly thought I talked to them before, so it's no way I didn't do this now, so I can actually finish up Omega majority of it. Now we can actually move on to the next quest thing that we're gonna be doing. And no, don't worry, it will not be planet scanning. I'll say planet scanning for like, I don't know, until I absolutely need to. And I'm gonna try to keep it down to a minimum. However, I will be 100% scanning every single planet before the game's done, because there is some interesting stuff that you can actually find on those worlds. There's actually one quest I've never ever come across because I just haven't checked stuff. So to make sure, so that's unexplored. Mega's been done. Didn't look at that, good. All right, so everything's still good there. I'm gonna buy the fuel and the probes, and I know that we have a quest for the Fothar system, so we're gonna head over there first. Which is all the way over there. Alright, we got two planets. I believe it's this one that we're supposed to be looking at. So here, yeah, so here's our first planet scan, guys. So obviously it's rich right now. So we're gonna find the distress signal first here. So we can shut that up.
In research projects, iridium is used to upgrade heavy weapons, submachine guns, and assault rifles.
Okay, anomaly detected. Signal scans detect transmitter matching Cerberus encryption. It is registered to an unknown deep cover operative. Cerberus operative life signs unconfirmed. Other transmissions that match known Eclipse coded communications also detected. Alright, we're just gonna go back to scanning. We're gonna scan this planet first before we do the thing here. Now how I usually like to do is I like going from top to bottom. Just seeing where everything spikes. Trying to find the highest point.
Probe launched. In research projects, palladium is used to upgrade heavy pistols, armor, and cybernetics.
So about there.
Launching probe. In research projects, platinum is used to upgrade sniper rifles, shotguns, and medical equipment.
Alright, so I'll be using a lot of palladium then. So we got one there. More palladium. Platinum, sorry. Okay, we have a spike here.
Launching probe.
Oh, need the planet to go that way. So about there is where that's capping out. That's a good balance between the two. That's a massive spike. So you're not going to actually notice much difference between these squares here. Like if you're over here and over here, you're not going to notice much difference. But when you go actually outside of that square, then you're going to start noticing the difference in the strength of the mineral signals. See, look, this is the exact same across here, but as soon as you go outside that line, then they start coming down.
Probe away.
Mm-hmm.
Launching probe.
And of course, when you actually get the scanner upgrades, it usually helps with the time that you spend scanning planets.
Probe away.
And of course, we keep going until obviously the planet says depleted.
Launching probe. Probe away.
Hey guys, isn't Mass Effect, isn't Mass Effect 2 so much fun? Alright, so it's highest about here.
Probe launched.
Bladium's always nice. Alright, so we have poor readings, which is a good sign. That means we're actually getting what we need.
Probe away.
So you're going to start seeing less spikes when you have a poor rating on your planet. Which means you're just going to have to do your best to get the highest peaks possible on the scanners, so. This will probably be the last thing on this planet. Nope, it's not. So there's one more good place then.
Probe away.
I doubt it's that one. So it's strongest there. Now it says depleted. Oops. Alright, now we can go ahead and land on the planet and do the quest. So yeah, that's planet scanning, guys. It's so much fun, isn't it? Of course, Garrison Morden. The alien funny team. Of course, I don't have anything to upgrade just yet because we haven't gotten a level. Alright, so make sure we're not missing anything here. Of course, platinum, like the first thing. And of course, all these planetary missions are like just quick things. Oh, by the way, I found out today that Dragon Age Origins are got put on backwards compatibility. And I literally just bought the game on Steam for, what was it, 10 bucks? About a week ago? So, that'll happen. Really? Not dead? And dead. And give me ammo to reload, please. Holding cell access. Subject ID, Interrogator Corporal Giro. Subject, Service Agent Tyrone Rawlings. Eclipse targeted Agent Rawlings some time ago. We know Rawlings is connected to the encrypted data we acquired. The data could conclusively prove Service's involvement with Rachni experiments. We believe Rawlings processes a cipher that could be used to encrypt the data. Without the cipher, the data could take years for Eclipse to decode. Subject captured. Agent Rawlings proved difficult to capture. Having insinuated himself, that means assume. Having assume himself, that doesn't make sense. On a ship bound for the Attican Traverse, he had won over the loyalty of the ship's crew who believed him to be a human dignitary on a mission to discovery. Our own agents managed to disable the ship and hobble its defenses long enough to distract Agent Rawlings. We lost a lot of men to obtain this asset, and this data had to be worth the expense. The interrogation failed despite some of our most recent interrogation techniques. These Rawlings managed to evade our questions. When we applied more invasive methods, he proved resistant to those as well. Eventually, Agent Rawlings' resistance caused tempers to flare. We consider unfortunate that Agent Rawlings did not live to pass on the cipher. We have men working to decipher the encryption now. As long as we control this data, its mere existence remains a powerful tool against Cerberus. Well, apparently not anymore. Oh, yeah, there's more. Hang on, bud. Need to check this back room for a minute. And a wall safe. And nothing else of value. Moving headshot. You're shooting through a wall, bud.
I'll tear you apart.
Oh, I'm out of ammo. There we go. And it appears we are clear, sir. Just gonna make sure I'm not missing anything. This looks like a secret room. Oh, this is the last place I need to go. I think. Okay, now I've already accessed those logs. Yeah, so that's the last place I need to go.
This computer contains the encrypted intelligence extracted from the captured Cerberus agent. The information could adversely affect Cerberus if
that's a yawn wall,
I mean.
Do it for myself.
Data received.
Alright. Experience game, 156. Almost got 8k from that. Platinum found, of course. We're all good. Alright guys, we're gonna hit up the Citadel, and that'll be it for this part on YouTube. Obviously, I'm still streaming for another 2 hours. Yeah, we'll do the Citadel. We'll do some stuff on the Citadel and then call it there. Actually, we'll do shopping on the Citadel first. Yeah, still streaming for about 2 hours, so don't worry. For those of you that are watching live on Twitch. Secure smuggle, recruit the convicts, the Krogan, help Zaid, that's the local cluster, investigate Project Overlord. Alright, cool. We'll head to the Citadel. And dock. So that's my webcam's kind of in a weird spot. What point do I keep going until I start seeing the microphone? There it is. There we go. That's where I want it. Nope, you can start seeing a little bit of dusk. There we go. Cool deal. It is a cool deal, bud. Yes, Morden, of course. Guys, we got some shopping to do. Still no level up.
Commander Shepard, enter the password and receive. Please tell me your password, Commander Shepard.
Silence is golden.
Good to finally meet you, Commander Shepard. Kasumi Goto. I'm a fan.
Has Cerberus filled you in on the mission?
Honestly, I'm shocked they didn't come to see me sooner. My fault for being hard to find, I guess.
What's with the password and the sneaking around? Are you in trouble or something?
I'm the best thief in the business, not the most famous. Need to watch my step to keep it that way. I also needed to make sure all this was legit. And I have no doubts now. You're the real Commander Shepard.
What makes you so sure?
There's a certain aura about you. Like you've seen things no one else has. Even without knowing what you looked like, I knew it was you.
What brought you to Cerberus?
That's a bit of a story. Short version, they were looking for me, so I trailed them to find out why. Turns out they were looking for someone to join you on an important mission, and were offering a serious signing bonus. I had a thing I needed help with, so I made them a deal. And here we are.
I assume this deal is something I should know about.
Yeah, I guess it slipped their minds. I'm looking for my old partner's gray box. A man named Donovan Hawk took it, and I'm planning to get it back.
What's this heist you're planning?
Not here, Shepard. You'll get a briefing when the time comes. I need time to nail down the details anyway. I've taken the liberty of getting you some evening wear, though. You want to look presentable.
What do you know about Donovan Hawk?
Mr. Hawk is a well-respected businessman. Arms dealer, murderer, generally not a great guy. His mansion's famous for being hard to crack, but I have a way in, and I think you're gonna love it.
I doubt Hawk's the kind of guy who takes kindly to people sneaking into his house.
I always expect trouble. That's why you're here.
I assume a gray box is some kind of hardware.
It's a neural implant. Illegal in most places. Stores memories, thoughts, secret codes, illicit information. This one in particular belonged to my partner, Keiji Okuda. We worked together for a long time, before Hawk killed him.
Tell me about this former partner of yours.
His name was Keiji Okuda. The best hacker and entryman I've ever known. Unfortunately, he slipped up and made himself infamous. He stole something he shouldn't. He warned me it was bad. Something that could spark interstellar war if it got out. That information got him killed.
What could he have found that's so bad?
He wouldn't say what it was, just that it was dangerous. He said if it got out, humanity would be in trouble. He encrypted it, wrapped it up in his own memories. To decode the information, you have to sift through all the time we spent together. Now those memories are all that's left of him.
I can understand why you'd want to get it back.
Getting it back will be easier with your help, Shepard.
If that's what Cerberus promised you, we'll get it done.
It'll be fun. And if we're lucky, you won't even have to draw your gun.
Oh, but we will.
We should probably wrap this up. You look pretty silly standing there talking to an advertisement. See you on the ship, Shepard.
Huh? Cheeky. Okay.
This recruits is a 20 kilo ferrous slug. Feel the weight. Every 5 seconds, the main gun of an Everest-class dreadnought accelerates 1 to 1.3% of light speed. It impacts with the force of a 38 kiloton bomb. That is 3 times the yield of the City Buster dropped on Hiroshima back on Earth. That means Sir Isaac Newton is the deadliest son of a bitch in space. Now, Serviceman Burnside, what is Newton's first law?
Sir, an object in motion stays in motion, sir.
No credit for partial answers, maggot!
Sir, unless acted on by an outside force, sir.
Damn straight! I dare to assume you ignorant jackasses know that space is empty. Once you fire this hunk of metal, it keeps going till it hits something. That can be a ship, or the planet behind that ship. It might go off into deep space and hit somebody else in 10,000 years. If you pull the trigger on this, you are ruining someone's day, somewhere and sometime. That is why you check your damn targets. That is why you wait for the computer to give you a damn firing solution. That is why, Serviceman Chung, we do not eyeball it. This is a weapon of mass destruction. You are not a cowboy shooting from the hip.
Sir, yes, sir.
Nice. We don't need to talk to the customs.
I'm sorry.
I thought it might be nice to come back here and see how it's changed, but it's just like it was. Same dirty streets, same unrepentant scavengers, same revolving door prisons. Being security here is a terrible job. This is exactly why I left.
Alright.
Looks like they've tightened up security.
Shut it down.
What? Do you seriously think?
Yeah, okay.
Sorry for the inconvenience, ma'am. Our scanners are picking up false readings. They seem to think you're, dead.
I was only mostly dead. Try finding that option on government paperwork.
We need to get that cleared up for you. Why don't you talk to my captain? He's just beyond the scanners on the right.
And you'll the have badass, to make him scream though. A
little. He's not gonna tell you everything just because you ask.
I know, sir.
If you don't have the stomach or you're worried about being reported, I can take care of it.
No, sir. I can handle it.
There you go.
Yes. I see the problem already, Commander Shepard. My console says you're dead.
You're not worried I'm some imposter claiming to be me?
We have the best screening equipment in the galaxy. Those scanners can sample DNA from skin flakes. Hell, if you have unregistered gene mods, they can even figure those out.
Your sergeant said you could help with that.
Usually you'd have to go through the station security administration to reactivate your IDs, then to customs and immigration to regain access to the Citadel itself, and probably a stop by the Treasury. Spending a year dead is a popular tax dodge. But I can see you're a busy woman. So how about I just press this button right here, and we call it done?
You're not big on formalities, are you?
I'm with them right up until they keep people from doing their jobs. There. I just saved you about 9 days of running around. That said, you should head up to the Presidium and tell them you're still alive. The Council probably wants to talk to the one who saved their scaly asses.
I will. Having access to the Council and the Spectre's resources would be useful.
Yeah. The Council can get anything. Best thing about working CSEC is that any equipment, information, or money you need, you get. Anyway, something else you need? Or can I get back to work?
Nope, you can return.
I should be going.
You need anything else, let me know.
Okay. So we're all good here. We're gonna head in over here first.
Good day, my friends. Welcome to the Citadel.
Classism? Listen, we're just going to be nice about this.
Since these stores are owned by the Council, do government employees get a discount?
Yes, in fact. What's your position?
I'm a former Spectre.
My goodness. I didn't know Spectres quit. I don't believe you qualify for a discount, though.
How about if I throw in an endorsement from the woman who defeated Saren?
You are Shepard?
There you go.
My goodness. The increase in sales would certainly be worth offering a discount.
What do you need me to do?
Just voice your endorsement into my console.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
Excellent. I will get my clerical VI to add it to our advertising immediately.
There you go. Okay. Oh, space hamster. We're not going to buy fish just yet. Because we need a certain object before we do that. Alright, so we did that. Where am I going here? Forget. I forget already.
I heard that those lakes up on the Presidium are filled with fish.
No, they're not.
You ever been up there?
No. C-Sec won't let me. They say I'm a risk.
They think every Krogan is dangerous.
Damn Turians. We should kill them all.
Don't kill the Turians, dude. Turians are the bros. They're the homies. I don't need to listen to that advertisement, like, at all. Didn't go in this shop.
I hear this is the best place for food on Zakharovard.
You heard wrong.
Ah, this is
the best place for food on the whole damn Citadel.
Yeah. Novels? I love how they throw in just, like, some real-life references. Drew Karpyshyn is a very active writer for novels currently. Like, he's still obviously alive today. And I love how they just throw in stuff like that. Alright, so... Alright, okay, so that's the special ingredients, which is fantastic. Alright, we should be able to get the Cerise Ice Brandy from Darkstar. We'll head up the stairs on the other side of that place and see what other stuff that we can get. Used ship.
Greetings,
ship salesman. God damn, I can't speak today. Okay, no idea what you just said. Rapid transit.
Oh, sorry, I'm trying to take a statement here.
There's nothing to talk about. She stole my credit shit. Arrest her.
I did not! Just because I'm a Quarian!
I need you to stop and take a deep breath.
You're mocking me, Earth Clan. Just because the Vault Clan need...
It was a poor choice of words, sir. I apologize.
You say you're falsely accused?
I was walking to the used ship dealer when he barged into me outside the Serta Foundation. He didn't stop or say he was sorry.
I already know where his credit shit is.
He runs up with C-Sec and accuses me of stealing his damn chip.
Do you spend a lot of time with the used ship dealer?
Yeah. They've got a lot of nice models. I'd like to buy one and take it back to the fleet, but...
A ship would make a great pilgrimage gift.
You know about the pilgrimage?
I traveled with Quarian, who was on hers.
Wow. I didn't know anyone here would do that for one of us.
You say she stole your credit chit?
She must have. When I left the Serta Foundation store, she ran right into me.
Are you sure you didn't leave your chit at the Serta Foundation?
Of course not. You think I'd make a mistake like that? I didn't even buy anything there. That chit stayed in my pocket.
Do you know who's telling the truth?
My Omni-Tool can tell the Quarian doesn't have a chit on her. But she could have stashed it to recover later. You know what Quarians are like. She's definitely a vagrant. I'll run her in and see what Bailey wants to do with her.
I'll see if I can find out what happened.
Ma'am, this is a C-Sec matter. We'll do all we... All we can to resolve this. We don't need civilian help. If you do happen to find the chit, please let one of our officers know.
Let's go.
Be careful out there.
Now, if I remember correctly, it's at one of two stores.
It's a delicacy back home.
There's a Volus outside who lost his credit chit. Did you happen to see him drop it anywhere?
I don't recall any other Vol clan entering my showroom today. Just that migrant clan girl putting her fingers all over the brochures again.
Can't remember if it was a store down in here or not. Alright, first we're gonna talk to Marab.
Welcome to Sarinus Applications. Can I interest you? Ah! Shepard!
Do I know you?
No, but I know you. Even a senile Hanar would remember the human who fought off the Geth. I thought you were dead.
Yeah, I've been getting that a lot.
Please, look around the store. It's a pleasure to have you here.
You know, I use quite a bit of software in my line of work.
It's a shame so few understand their own equipment. Besides the most obvious point-and-go nav interfaces, anyway.
You wouldn't believe how often I hear, why is the ship turning around? We're only halfway there.
Oh, I would.
You know, I like your products. Any interest in an endorsement from the human who defeated Saren?
I'd be thrilled. But I don't think I could afford to pay you for it.
Don't worry about it. What if we just worked out a discount?
Absolutely. Just speaking to my console here.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store in the Citadel.
That will be splendid. I can edit that and have it working right away. Thank you so much.
Okay. So tech damage for 75, damage protection for 75. We're going to pass on that just for now. Because it's a little bit pricey and we don't have a whole lot to work with.
What do you think, Michael? Maybe the immunobooster? It's supposed to help with alien bacteria.
Good day, citizen. Welcome to the Serta Foundation outlet on Zakara Ward.
I couldn't help but notice your prices. They seem a bit steep.
With respect, the Foundation is not concerned with profits. A portion of our sales funds research to cure genetic diseases.
You know, it would make your services more popular. An endorsement from the woman who defeated Saren.
Oh my! You're Shepard, aren't you? I would be glad to give you my employee discount if you would do that for us.
It's a deal.
Do it!
Just speak into my console here.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
I'm totally not whoring out my character for discounts.
Thank you.
Absolutely not. Are you crazy to think I'd do that? Like, come on, dude. Okay, and then we're going
to
ask him. Ask
Welcome
her.
Welcome to the Serta Foundation outlet on Zakara Ward.
Avolus was in here not too long ago. Did he drop a credit chip?
And not that I saw. He didn't purchase anything.
Oh. Okay, well, then I know what
Thanks
store
for
it
your
is.
Time.
Come back soon, Shepard.
Alright, Serta Foundation. Medigel capacity and life support webbing. We're going to buy both of these because they're extremely useful.
The nerve enhancements say that there are occasional motor control side effects.
And shipping warehouse, I don't think has anything in it. Everyone's going to check for scan stuff.
No, they said to go to the warehouse. This is the warehouse.
Yeah, no, we're good.
Look, it took me a long time to get this refund. It's a decision.
I felt her hand go into my pocket. When I checked, my credit chip was gone.
Yo, Volus, you're high as fuck. Is the store literally furthest away from this dude? It's not the cafe, it's the, this person.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my...
Welcome back. These stores are owned by the Citadel.
Never mind.
That's correct. Citadel souvenirs outlets are owned by the Council government. The profits generated, we offer an assortment of decorations.
Thanks for your time.
Never mind.
Of course, citizen.
Am I retarded? Maybe? I mean, I know I'm dumb, but I'm pretty dumb. Or was it somewhere up top? It might have been a vendor up top, I think. Yeah, because there's more stores up here. Oh, I think I know who it was.
What can I do for you?
I thought weapons were restricted on the Citadel now.
Carrying them around is. Selling them isn't. We store them in off-site containers and deliver them to your ship. People who have permission to carry, like C-Sec, can walk out with them.
I'd like to buy something.
Try our electronic catalog interface.
Now here's the best part.
Tell
this
me
is
about
the
your
best
services.
Thing.
We sell quality hunting supplies, which you'll need when you purchase one of our adventure travel packages. Imagine it, human. The break of day. You and your team have been stalking a Shatha for 5 days. In that time, it's killed 4 men. You see it? Line it up. Take the shot. Blam! It's down. You're the hero. That's what we offer. Not a vacation, but an experience.
I love it.
Your expeditions might be a little tame for me.
Tame? A human can hardly take down a Feral Varen, let alone a Shatha. Who do you think you are?
Well, my name's Shepard, and I...
The Shepard? The one that put down Saren Arterius?
Oh, you do know me.
By the spirits, Shepard, in my store. I don't suppose I could convince you to record an advertisement for me.
Sure you could. Can we work out a discount?
A discount? I'd name my firstborn after you if you ask. Can we record it now? Just speak towards my console.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
No other gun shop has that kind of endorsement.
That's very true. Alright. Sniper rifle weapon upgrade for 50k. I'll grab that. And Aegis vest. And we'll also grab the sniper rifle damage.
We can use this!
And there's one last shot.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
Game salesman.
Have you tried Galaxy of Fantasy yet? I love that game. It's based on Turian mythology, but it's really fun. I hear it has 11 billion players now. Do you have any games you'd like to trade in? You get 2 credits toward a new game. You know what's good? Alliance Corsair. The battles are pretty realistic, but it's still fun. And you can install it on an Omni-Tool. For 10 credits, we offer data protection for any game we sell. If the copy protection ever malfunctions, you can download a new copy free. Those Asari Hanar porn games they sell in Shinakiba are really nasty.
Well, that's all he has to say. Alright, so this is Darkstar. We need to go in there to get the Srice Ice Brandy, obviously. Oh, the people want to hear your story.
Khalees have been seen in Al-Jalani, Westerly News.
Yep.
I interviewed you 2 years ago when you first became a Spectre. You presented your case very well on camera. Do you have a minute?
You spent the whole time trying to make me look like I was selling out Earth to the Council.
You proved me wrong in the end. Now that you've resurfaced, you're news again. I just want to give your story its due.
Fine, for now.
Sources claim you were at the heart of the Presidium during the Battle of the Citadel. It's fair to say the course of the battle hinged on your words. If true, you told Admiral Hackett to assist the Destiny Ascension, costing hundreds of human lives, and securing the continued dominance of the Citadel Council.
Saving everyone only happens in vids. There will be sacrifices. Being in charge means making sure they lead to the greater objective. That's a reality shared by all soldiers, in command and on the ground. Don't you dare suggest I made that call lightly.
I didn't mean to accuse...
You're damn right you didn't. I won't have you disrespect any of those who gave their lives that day. They are heroes, all of them. They deserve better than you.
Oh.
Commander Shepard, first human Spectre. Hero of the Battle of the Citadel. Check vid. We get it? Great. Bull rushed on my own show.
Savage. I think I forget what goddamn store the dude left it at. I thought I remembered, but apparently I didn't.
I wish they still made role-playing games like they used to. These days, it's all big choices and visceral combat. I miss those old games, where you had to remember to drink water, and it took 5 hours real time to fly somewhere.
That turning animation, though. So good. Alright, let's pick up the Srice Ice Brandy while we're here as well, and finish off the collect quests. Just like that. Alright, we're gonna find out what store Mr. Dumbass left his credit shit at. I swear it was one of these.
I'm Commander Shepard, and this is my favorite store on the Citadel.
Welcome back.
Nope.
I'm just browsing.
Of course. Take your time.
I swear it was an Asari woman. I gave it. Yeah, it's a carrier cafe. I can't do anything there. Nobody to talk to. So it has to be on the lower level then.
The Destiny Ascension has completed its 20 colony victory cruise. Council members aboard thanked Human Alliance soldiers for their efforts in repelling Saren's invasion 2 years ago.
Hiroshima!
You know what Quarians are like. They take anything not welded to the deck.
Calm down, bro.
Commander Shepard, and this is...
Good day, citizen. Welcome to the Serta Foundation.
Avalis was in here not too long.
And now that I saw, he did.
Okay.
Thanks for your time.
Come
her.
Back soon, Shepard.
I'm Commander.
So this dude then?
My favorite customer.
Avalis
what can I?
Avalis was in here. Not
there he is.
He bought some environmental system drivers, then left without his chit. I didn't notice he'd left until he was already gone. If you see him, tell him I have it here behind the counter.
Did all that.
Thanks for your time. I'll be here.
Just end up back here, because I swore that I was an Asari woman that had it. Alright, so, yo, dude.
Please move along.
You forgot your credit chit at Saranus Applications. The clerk's holding it for you.
Oh. Well, the Quarium could have stolen it.
I'll close his event report, but I'll be watching you. Get a permanent residence, or I'll run you in for vagrancy.
Are you too serious?
What?
You falsely accused this girl of stealing from you. All you have to say now is that she could have stolen it?
Now, just a minute.
And you? She gets harassed and insulted by this guy, and you throw in a threat to arrest her for vagrancy.
How about if I run you in for obstruction of justice?
You think you're gonna run in a former Spectre? I think both of you should get out of here.
Son of a...
Thank you. I wish I could give you something more than words.
What the hell was that C-Sec guy's problem? He had no evidence that you did anything wrong.
I don't know. Everyone's been like that since I got here.
And problem solved. Okay, we're gonna do the thing, guys. Okay, for those of you watching on YouTube, thanks so much for watching. I'll catch you guys next time.